Hi, in this tutorial, we are going to create a wireframe effect, which can be applied to objects or floors. First, create a material and click to open a window. Next, set the blend mode of the material to translucent and check two-sided. Go to tessellation and set it to flat tessellation and check crack-free displacement. Create an absolute world position node and an object position node. After creating a subtract node, connect the absolute world position node and the object position node to the subtract node to create the relative position of the object. Next, create an FMOD node and click while holding down the S on the keyboard to create a parameter node. Set the name and value of the parameter node. Then, connect the subtract node and the parameter node to the FMOD node. When you preview the FMOD node, you will see repeating lines in each direction. Next, hold down M on the keyboard and click to create a multiply node, then connect the FMOD node to pins A and B of multiply. Next, create a 1- node and connect it to the multiply node so that the lines in each direction appear clearly. After creating the max node, set the value of the max node to 0 and connect it with the 1- node. Next, create a dot product node and connect it with the max node. Then, hold down keyboard 1 and click to create a constant node. After setting the value to 1, connect it to the dot node. Now, when you connect the dot node to the opacity of the material, you will see repeating lines in each direction. Next, hold down number 3 on the keyboard and click to create a constant 3-vector node and convert it to a parameter. Next, create a parameter node and a multiply node. Select a name and value from the parameter and a color from the constant 3-vector node. Connect the two nodes to the multiply node. After that, connect the multiply node to emissive color to color the line. Next, create a vertex normal node and a parameter node and set the parameter name and value. Then, while holding down D on the keyboard, click to create a divide node, set the value to about 10, and connect it to the parameter node. Finally, create a multiply node and connect the vertex normal node and divide node to the multiply node, and then connect the multiply node to the world displacement node. Save and return to the content browser. Create a material instance by right-clicking on the wireframe material created so far. Next, place the desired mesh in the level in the place actor. Now, after applying the instance to the mesh placed in the level, open the instance window and adjust the parameters to see the change in the wireframe.